The first tale of Shadowgate concluded with the evil warlock lord battling the young hero atop the Well of Souls far beneath Castle Shadowgate. The warlock lord had summoned a being, the behemoth from the Netherworlds, and with this creature under his power, he planned to conquer the world. But with a blast from the fabled staff of ages, the young hero broke the warlock lord's control over the beast. The behemoth turned on its former master, and the warlock lord was dragged down into the Netherworld by the very creature he sought to control. The young hero, now king of the land, realized that the power within Shadowgate would always tempt those who would use its magic for evil. So he became the first of a dynasty, the line of kings, who took it as their mandate to keep safe the power of Shadowgate. The second tale of Castle Shadowgate is that of Prince Eric, distant descendant of the young hero, whose father now protects Shadowgate. Prince Eric has for many years traveled abroad, gaining wisdom in preparation for the day when he assumes his father's role. In his 18th year, a message from his distant homeland reaches Eric. It is from his father's new advisor, Balazar, and it bears grim news. My liege, it is with great sadness that I inform you that your father, King Erend, has been murdered. While your troops search the lab for his assassin, you must return home and assume your rightful place on the throne. As his ship steers a course towards Kaltorden's shores, Eric's thoughts are of the family he left behind when his journeys began. He remembers his country, Kaltorden, a land of great beauty, as well as potential danger. He remembers fondly his father, King Erend, whose wisdom and kindness has guided Kaltorden for 30 years. And perhaps, most fondly of all, he remembers his younger sister, Elizabeth. At last, Eric reaches Kaltorden, his birthplace, and now, his kingdom. His grief over his father's death is all but forgotten when he sees how his beloved sister has grown in his absence. Eric is introduced to Balazar, his father's advisor. While Balazar seems charming and intelligent, Eric still feels a strange unease about him. With a shrug, Eric dismisses his odd apprehension, and they begin to discuss Eric's coronation. But suddenly, two soldiers seize Prince Eric.
The assassin has been captured,
they claim.
And the villain says he was hired by Prince Eric himself.
Couldn't wait to seize the throne, eh, Prince?
Shouts Balazar as they drag the bewildered prince to the dungeons.
You'll wear no crown without a head.
And this is how Eric's greatest adventure and the second tale of Shadowgate begins.
Get in there, you scum!
Oh, Eric!
Elizabeth!
I know you are innocent, my brother. Something evil has befallen the kingdom, and I don't trust Balazar. I keep thinking of poor father.
I'll have to find a way out of here. As the last of the line of kings, I'll avenge father's death. I swear!
There is more to the events of the last few weeks than the murder of the king and false arrest of his heir. Their looms a far greater threat, which you must ultimately face within the walls of Shadowgate. I will be with you when I can.
Ho, 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 ho